Welcome to the making of Tell Somebody, the new CD from Southern Gospel's best new mixed quartet, the Williamsons. A stellar recording such as Tell Somebody doesn't just happen overnight. It takes a lot of time, hard work, prayer, finances, and a strong team to create something this special. After much prayer, they chose just the right songs from hundreds written by some of today's best Southern Gospel writers. The team included Producer of the Year, Donna King, Booking Agent, Michael Davis of the Dominion Agency, and yours truly, 37-year Southern Gospel veteran, Les Fox, in management. With everything in place, it was time to begin.
All the songs they sang were beautiful, and sure my heart was stirred. But what brought?
Sure my heart was stirred.
Yeah, just sure my heart was stirred, and you got it. That was really.
The songs they sang were beautiful, and sure my heart was stirred. But what brought me to the altar was the word. It was the word of God that brought. Oh, it was the word of God that brought me. That felt good. That felt good.
Do what?
She's talking, but I can't hear her.
What? I couldn't hear you. I was talking to Ken. He's my friend, yeah. Yeah.
God brought me to my knees that day in prayer, knowing I was so unworthy of his love. Oh, the songs they sang were beautiful, and sure my heart was stirred. But what brought me to the altar was the word.
My knees that day in prayer, knowing I was so unworthy of his love. Oh, the songs they sang were beautiful, and sure my heart was stirred. But what brought me to the altar was the word.
Now let's talk to Donna King, producer of Tell Somebody. Donna, why did you want to work with the Williamsons?
Well, I have known Donnie and Lisa for years. We've crossed paths over the years just in the various music industry functions and meetings and so forth. And I've always had the utmost respect for their attitude and their work ethic, their professionalism. All those things were already stand out to me. But what I hadn't had the chance to experience was their musical ability and their heart for ministry. I think when you're in those meeting things, you can miss out on, you know, what are these people like inside, down deeper, you know, because we talk about all kinds of things like, well, we're planning this concert event, or we're trying to bring some attention to the Southern Gospel Music Guild or whatever. But I got to talking to Donnie. He came to me and asked about possibly working with me, and I was really hopeful because I've always sensed that they have a great attitude and a great desire to keep on growing and getting stronger at what they do. So it became evident as we talked that not only did they want to have a wonderful professional and centered ministry, but they also wanted to do everything that they do for the glory of God. And, you know, I think besides their talent, which is outstanding, I'm sitting in this room this week. We are working so hard, but I'm sitting in this room this week with some of the greatest singers in gospel music. Lisa Williamson, bar none, has the most incredible alto voice, and Carl can soar up into the heavens. We have to kind of pull his feet down sometimes. He is so solid up there, and he's a strong lead singer, and then their bass, and Donnie's singing the baritone, and they're just amazing vocal talents. Lisa writes a lot of the music, so that's incredible. I could just go on and on about the reasons I wanted to work with them, but as I got to know Donnie more, and we communicated about the purpose of this project and about what needed to be there as far as the lyrical content, I realized that not only was I going to get to be a part of a talented group and producing a talented group, but also a group that was completely focused on every bit of the glory going to God. And I'm just excited about what's ahead for these guys. They're a big thing now, but they're the next big thing.
What are your hopes and aspirations for the Williamsons and Tell Somebody?
You know, I love the title of the CD. It's called Tell Somebody. We've already chosen it. We talked about it again. The purposes, just putting everything together and the way that God wove the messages of these songs together has been incredible. And really, truly, what I pray for this project is that it would reach ears that Donnie and Lisa and Carl and Darren never dreamed could be reached. That it will expand their boundaries in ways that they never never dreamed, that they will be standing on stages in places they never imagined, not because they need to be some big, huge, famous group, but because their message needs to reach hurting hearts. One of the songs on this project is called There's Healing for the Hurting, which I was so blessed and privileged to get to write with Carl Rice. This is his first recorded song on an album. And that song has got to be heard. These songs have got to be heard. So our purpose and our prayer is that people will hear these songs so that their lives can be touched and they can be pulled up out of the really dark places that people can find themselves in. Because if we don't sing about hope, we have nothing to sing about.
Now let's meet the Williamsons with your host, Ken Grady, recorded live at the Creekside Gospel Music Convention.
We are at the Creekside Gospel Music Convention with some good friends of ours. These are the Williamsons from Oklahoma, and we want to welcome you guys to gospel music today.
Well, thank you, Brother Ken. Good to be with you.
I'm going to ask Donnie to introduce the group.
All right. Well, standing to my left is Darren Hebert, singing the bass part. He's from a little town in East Louisiana called Oak Grove, and this is my wife, Lisa. And standing behind me here is Carl Rice from Summerfield, North Carolina.
Now, I want to tell you, we want to talk about your new CD. And just while we were waiting to set this up, we were talking to someone who said she got the new CD and listened to it all the way from wherever she lives to here in Pigeon Forge and never took it out of the CD player. And we have had the same reaction. It is a great CD.
Well, thank you. It's certainly the best thing we've ever done, but we put a lot more effort into this. We've always tried to make good projects, but this one we got some folk to help us who, you know, we're the best producers in Waleka, Oklahoma. But we decided this time that we would get somebody who knows really what they're doing, and we hired Donna King, who is an award-winning producer, and my goodness, she pulled stuff out of us we didn't know we had, and that's telling the truth.
Lisa does a lot of recording and production, mm-hmm. So let me ask her this question. Just run us through the steps in making a CD. I mean, it's not just... You don't just set up a mic in your living room and sing in it.
No. Of course, in our situation, we actually drove to Nashville and did the tracks there and had some great players on there. Gary Prim was the session leader, piano player. I can't remember all the other guys, but I know him. And then
Dave Cleveland.
Yeah, Dave Cleveland was on guitar. I mean, just incredible players. And then they rough mixed those tracks. We came back to Donna's studio and did our vocals there. And which is, that in itself is a process, you know, but it's, man, it sure turned out good. I mean, like Donnie said, I'll just echo what he said. We have never been more proud of a project than this one. This is my favorite by far. So super excited.
We got to visit on one of the days, and that just recording the vocals is a meticulous project.
Especially when you're working with Donna King. Yeah. We spent 8 days recording vocals on that project. Let me say one more thing about getting a good quality project. You have to have good material. You have to have good songs. It's all about the song. And Donna, with her background and her being kind of in the loop of things here in Nashville with some great, great writers, she went through probably 200 songs. We went through several ourselves. She narrowed that down to maybe 50 that we all began to go through together. And it was just an amazing process just going through all this material. But I think we've come up with some really great songs.
Mm-hmm. And it's not just the best songs. It's the best songs for the Williamsons.
For us. Yeah. Yes,
exactly.
Yeah.
We haven't mentioned the name of the CD yet.
Well, we actually titled the CD after a song that Lisa wrote. She wrote her first effort at writing a spiritual, and it's called I've Got to Tell Somebody. And so we titled the CD Tell Somebody.
Mm-hmm. And we've seen the things on Facebook, and what a great title. I mean, it just works for every...
Well, everything has a hashtag nowadays, and that was Donna's deal, you know, hashtag Tell Somebody. So yeah. That's kind of been our advertising campaign the last few months.
It is great. What's the Williamsons website?
It is www.williamsonsmusic.com.
Okay, and the CD is available there.
Sure is, available there, available on iTunes and Amazon and all those regular places.
Okay. It is our favorite CD in a long time, and we hope it goes where it should go.
Well, thank you. We do, too.
All right. All the Williamsons, thanks for being on Gospel Music today.
Well, we hope you've enjoyed the making of Tell Somebody. To purchase Tell Somebody, featuring the hit single, It Was the Word, written by Lisa Williamson, please go to williamsonmusic.com. To book the Williamsons, contact the Dominion Agency at thedominionagency.com. Management provided by Butler Music Group. Now, let's cue the outtakes.
He ain't even licking.
Darren's getting closer to Lisa.
Okay. Darren, Brent.
I'm going to bring the camera in.
Need the lights in.
Hello.
There's the wrinkles. Okay.
Looks like a family portrait. Okay.
Wait, the doctor.
Yeah. I think that's it.